I think we can't even imagine how our lives are going to change with quantum computing. It's going to be absolutely world-changing, even more so than AI.
Early investors are pouring into quantum computing stocks, with some smaller companies up nearly 2,000% this year.
You have to be ready for 50% haircuts in very small companies if something goes wrong. The real speculative names are the ones that get hit first.
Marc Lichtenfeld, the chief income strategist at the Oxford Club, shares a list of three safer companies that are already making huge strides in quantum computing.
It's just a much more stable investment. These are mature companies, $1.7 billion in cash with no debt. It's a company a lot of people aren't paying attention to.
Plus, he'll share some of his research into a little-known picks and shovel play that's already taking off with all of the new investment in quantum computing. Let's dive in. Marc, so great to have you back on the show talking about a topic that's been really quite explosive over the past year, and that's quantum computing. There's several different speculative plays out there, pure play stocks that have seen almost 2,000% growth over the past year as more and more investors are interested in quantum computing. I know that you are the expert. You study this area a lot. So just talk about why we're seeing so much growth in quantum computing right now.
Well, it's really very, very early on. I mean, if you compare it to AI, for example, certainly everybody knows about artificial intelligence at this point. I'm sure a lot of your viewers have used ChatGPT or at least played around with it. And even if they haven't, they're hearing about it in the news and certainly in the investing world. And I would argue that perhaps AI is in like the third, maybe fourth inning. It's at least from an investment standpoint. It's still very early on in the game. But people are clearly aware of it. We're seeing it being used every day, and the investment thesis is very well known. Quantum computing, I would argue, even though, as you mentioned, some stocks have really exploded, really just the first pitch in the first inning has been thrown because, you know, it's not part of the mainstream discussion. It's not part of really the mainstream in investing, and it's really not being used every day yet like AI is. Quantum computing has a much longer runway. And it's just much, much earlier, and I think a better opportunity.
Yeah, talk about the technology a little bit. We don't need to dive all the way into the nitty-gritty details, but mainly, how is quantum computing going to be different than AI, and what kind of potential is there?
It's really mind-boggling. So the most incredible statistic that I saw, or factoid, Google has a quantum computer, and they were able to solve a very, very complex problem, to put it lightly. It solved this problem in 5 minutes, and it would take the world's fastest supercomputer 10 septillion years to solve that problem. So just to give you an idea of what 10 septillion looks like, that's a one with 25 zeros. It's something like a million billion times longer than the universe has been around. Like I said, it's mind-boggling stuff how fast quantum computers can solve these very, very complex problems and kind of the information that they'll be able to provide us. You know, right now, AI can kind of take all the knowledge in the world and learn from it and break it down and kind of regurgitate it and give it to us in very useful ways, in perhaps ways we haven't thought of. Quantum computing is going to discover new knowledge and in ways that we can't even imagine at this point. I mean, drug discovery, just, you know, routing data or energy when there's a disaster. It's going to be absolutely world-changing, I think, even more so than AI.
And it's not just the companies working to develop quantum computing that are going to benefit from all of this investment. It's also those picks and shovels plays that are working to support this research and development through new technology and equipment and other areas that are also going to see a huge boost with all of this new investment into quantum computing. I know, Marc, you've been working on this research for a while, and it's all released in your latest report. You can scan the QR code now or click the link in the description of this video to really get a deeper look at Marc's research into the companies that are supporting quantum computing. We are going to touch on some of that research a little bit later on in this video. But first, Marc, let's get to your list of three less speculative companies that are really already making huge breakthroughs in quantum computing research and development.
Sure. So the first one is Google, as I mentioned just a minute ago. They're one of the companies that is already developing this technology that is going to be a leader. I mean, no doubt about it. They've got the resources. They are an 800-pound gorilla in the space. Kind of can't go wrong betting on Google when it comes to emerging technologies. So to me, that's a kind of a no-brainer.
Let's talk about Google's such a giant, like you said. They have so many different avenues and different parts of their business. How big of a deal could quantum computing be for such a large company? If they make a major breakthrough in this space, will it move the needle on their stock?
I think it will. I think it'll take a little while, though. So if they come out with some new discovery in quantum computing, like I said, with that chip that solved that problem in 5 minutes. At this point, because Google is such a behemoth, I think quantum computing information isn't going to necessarily send the stock up 20, 30% in a day. It's such a giant stock. It takes a lot to really get it going. So I think it's much more of a longer term play as quantum computing continues to develop and then eventually becomes a meaningful part of its business. I think Google is one of those stocks you're going to want to be in for sure.
As we're talking about this big name, I'm wondering if quantum computing developments and research could follow the road of what AI has done. And that's every major Mag 7 company out there now has their own AI research, own AI development, creating their own different data centers and things. Could we see something similar from quantum computing in the future?
It's possible. I mean, one of the issues with quantum computing is it's very expensive. And so it wouldn't surprise me if, yes, some of the giant companies are, develop it themselves, but I also think it's quite possible you're going to see acquisitions, you're going to see outsourcing to the experts rather than develop those teams internally. So I think you're going to get a good mixture of it. Perhaps some of the smaller companies, well, I do like Google and another company I'll talk about in a minute that is a giant company. Some of the smaller companies have tremendous opportunities as well because everybody's going to need it, and they're not going to necessarily want to build it themselves, especially if somebody else has that expertise already.
Yeah, very good point. We'll get to a smaller company in a little bit, but first let's move on to your second pick. It's a familiar name and an old name, and that's why I think this one's really interesting.
Yeah, another giant company, IBM. And as you said, it's an old name, and people think of it as kind of an old stodgy computer company from the 1970s. But IBM has consistently been on the forefront of all kinds of new and emerging technologies. And this is no different. They are developing their own quantum computing expertise. One of the issues with quantum computing is that it does produce a bunch of errors. So all the companies are trying to figure out ways of making this much more error-free. And IBM had the first scalable error-free quantum computer available. Well, they expect it to be the first error-free quantum computer available in about 2029. So that's pretty exciting if they can be first to market with a computer that really is much more accurate than what else is out there.
Yeah, I think there's a different turnaround story here between Google and IBM. They're both familiar companies, but like you said earlier with Google, that's such a large company that quantum computing might not have a major, huge impact. Could this company and this stock see a much larger bounce if they do come through with the technology for that first quantum computer that's successful?
I think that's real possible because, as you alluded to, it's an old company, and I think it doesn't have that reputation as being really one of the tech leaders anymore, like a Google does and even a Microsoft does. I think people still kind of feel IBM is that old company that's not doing anything new. And if they can show that they are at the forefront of quantum computing, it's likely that you're going to get a lot of new investors to the story, people that weren't looking at it before. And so I think it's possible that the stock performs really, really well because of that kind of that somewhat negative sentiment, or it, maybe even if it's not negative sentiment, I think it's a company a lot of people aren't paying attention to.
I think that's very true. It's not a name that most people think about in the quantum computing space. I do want you to weigh a little bit the pros and cons of a lot of investors who are looking at quantum computing are looking at those pure play up and coming companies that have seen the tremendous growth from being a teeny tiny stock at the start of the year to still being a small stock in a small company, but they're very speculative plays. What are the pros and cons lens of going with a company like IBM, if you're interested in quantum computing investing, that's maybe more established, maybe has some different avenues for revenue and for growth. Talk about those factors a little bit.
A company like IBM or Google is a very stable company. If they have weak earnings, chances are the stock's not going to drop, precipitously. These are mature companies, and these would be investments for the long haul that while you're holding those stocks, you're probably not going to get hurt too badly. They'll probably steadily rise over time. So it's just a much more stable investment. If you go to the small speculative companies, I think the upside is much, much higher. As you mentioned, these are explosive companies. It could be up 100,000 times, maybe even, depending on how small and what the news is. But obviously, that is way more speculative. You have to be ready for 50% haircuts in very small companies if something goes wrong, or even if there's just a bear market, even if there's no news, but markets correct, the real speculative names are the ones that get hit first. So if you are going to invest in those, super speculative names, position size accordingly so that if the stock does drop and drops hard, you're not getting hurt too badly.
Very good advice, Mark. And we are ready to get to that third name, which is the more speculative play in quantum computing investing. It's a stock that a lot of our investors who are looking for that extreme growth are definitely paying attention to right now in quantum computing.
Yeah, and that's IonQ. And what I like about this company is first of all, some of the financials. A lot of times with very speculative companies, you don't have, they have no money in the bank and they're constantly raising money and having to sell more stock. IonQ has $1.7 billion in cash with no debt. Now, they're not cash flow positive, so they will have to raise money at some point in the future, no doubt about it. But it's not like they're starving for cash right now. So I really like the fact that they have that big bankroll with no debt. And they're also a quantum, they do make hardware, but they're also quantum computing as a service. So as I mentioned when you asked the question about the Mag 7 and perhaps other companies, I think there are a lot of companies out there are going to outsource their quantum computing needs to the experts. And IonQ would be one of those types of companies. They're a smaller company, certainly could get acquired. I think any of these companies that have a foothold in quantum computing have a potential to be acquired. You never should buy a stock just because you think it could get acquired, but it's kind of a nice feather in its cap as far as another reason to own the company. So, and then stock's done quite well over the past year. And I think this is one that's a really interesting and exciting company if you want to be a little bit on the smaller side and speculative.
Yeah, we've talked about a few of the different names in the speculative plays, and IonQ is one of a few that are really popular with investors in quantum computing space. Is it just that solid financials, the debt story that you talked about, that has IonQ above some of the smaller speculative plays in your mind for quantum computing?
It's interesting. I don't think a lot of investors, especially the ones that are speculating, are paying that close attention to the financials. And especially in a case like this where they're not cash flow positive, they're not, generating profits yet. But I like that. It gives me a little bit of comfort that they don't need to immediately go raise money. Like I said, they will eventually. They'll have to eventually. But I like the fact that I can get in now, and perhaps now the stock rises another 50% over the next year. I'm just making up that number. And then if it does, they can raise money at a higher valuation. They don't have to dilute shareholders as much. So having that much longer runway until they need to raise money makes it much better for shareholders that they wouldn't get diluted as much as if the stock is lower and this company's really struggling.
A really important thing to consider, and I like that perspective to share when you're looking at speculative plays, different factors to consider of what could be the best long-term play for investors who are getting in on the early side of quantum computing. Another thing that you have to talk about that I think is so interesting in this space is we're talking about these quantum computing stocks that are doing the research and building the computers and trying to get these successful quantum computers up and running. But there's another side to that, and that's more of the picks and shovels, the different industries out there that could be supporting quantum computing. What have you found in that area?
Yeah, so I love picks and shovels companies in every industry. I mean, that's where the real money is made, in my opinion. And I learned that lesson the hard way during the dot-com boom and bust. I was working in San Francisco during the dot-com boom and bust. So, I saw, yes, for every Amazon that made it and made it big, there were 100, maybe 1,000 other dot-com companies that did not make it. But the companies like the Ciscos, the Oracles, and the Intels, all the companies that were providing the tools that all the dot-coms needed were the ones that made it and consistently generated revenue. Even when the dot-coms weren't generating any revenue, these companies were. They're generating profits. So I've always been a very big fan of picks and shovels companies, regardless of industry, but especially in these new and emerging industries that, you know, we kind of don't know where they're going to land and who the big winners are going to be. To me, the picks and shovel companies are going to be the big winners. And I'm always looking for those types of companies.
It's really good advice, especially in an emerging industry like quantum computing, where like you, we've talked about some of these smaller speculative companies. Who knows if 5 years from now they'll still be around, or you know, if they'll actually get to the goal of what they've been doing all of this investment and research on. So that's a good area to look, is those picks and shovels. And you have recently found one that is really going to rise as there's so much new investment going into quantum computing.
Yeah, and it's a fascinating company. They're small. And what I love about it is they're the only American company that's providing a certain disruptive quantum computing component that requires virtually no power to cool, which is very exciting because, you know, one of the big problems with AI, with quantum computing, you know, with all of our computing power is that they need so much energy. And a lot of that energy is just to cool them down. This particular component that can be used in quantum computing makes it so that that is not necessary. And it's the only American company that makes this. And so not only is that a feel-good story, I believe that's going to be a very important national security situation, as all the world, but especially China and Russia, are racing into quantum computing. I mean, this is going to be an arms race in computing, because if you think about the uses for it, I mean, we're talking, you know, cyber attacks, you know, encryption, the uses for quantum computing against, you know, other countries, against enemies, what have you, is pretty significant. It could be a very significant threat. So having a company that's the only American company that makes this component, I think is really kind of vital to national security and the whole American quantum computing environment.
Yeah, quantum computing is absolutely going to have a huge impact across the globe as this race heats up and continues. This stock that you're talking about sounds really interesting. It's something that your company researches all the time. That's what the Oxford Club is all about, taking a deep dive into finding these companies with tremendous potential. I know our viewers are probably noticing you haven't mentioned that stock ticker yet, and that is because it's all about the research on your organization. We have a QR code you can scan right now, or a link in the description of the video if you really want to dive into Marc's research. He has a really in-depth report on what this company is and why it's going to be so successful. You can again find that right now by scanning the QR code or clicking the link in the description of this video. Marc, any final thoughts you want to leave with our viewers today about this company or just this whole sector?
I think we can't even imagine how our lives are going to change with quantum computing. Just like perhaps in 1995, we couldn't imagine how the world was going to look, you know, with the internet and how it was going to impact our lives. It has so much potential for positive things. Everyday life, I think, is going to be so effective. We're going to have so much more knowledge in, let's say, 10 years, 15 years than we do today because of these computers' powers to discover new things that we didn't even know existed. You know, just going back to drug discovery, it's going to discover molecules that exist in the world that we weren't aware of, and then that those molecules can cure disease. So it's really going to be mind-boggling stuff, and I think it's kind of the stuff of science fiction, but it's becoming real, and it's becoming realer, you know, pretty much every month. If you kind of follow the news, you'll see every month there's just some new little thing that's advancing this and getting us closer to reality and having this being a part of our lives.
It's going to have a huge impact. And like you said, it might seem like science fiction, but we are getting closer to that development. And there's so many things that we have today that at one point seemed like science fiction are now very much reality. And I think quantum computing will will be that same story. Marc, thank you so much for really getting into the details on this sector, sharing some great companies that investors might not be thinking of when it comes to quantum computing, and for sharing a little tease of that really great picks and shovel company that you've discovered too. Thanks again for your time, Marc. And thank you, viewers, for watching us today. We always appreciate your time. Let us know in the comments what you think about these companies. Is it a different perspective on quantum computing than you'd had? Are there other speculative plays that you're interested in? We'd love to hear from you in the comments. As always, happy investing.